This is my not French cleat storage system for hand tools and such. Everything has got its own holders, and the holders are just screwed onto the backing plywood, sometimes just a screw straight in there. And unlike a French cleat system, if I have to move something, sometimes I've been left with a few screw holes like here and here, although usually I can cover those up. But realistically, if you have a French cleat system, once you have it set up, you hardly ever move anything, so I think to have a few extra holes is much less ugly than having these French cleats that can catch chips and dust. One of my favorite things here is this drill index, which was originally in this box down here, but I'd keep it by the drill press, and as I'm drilling, chips would always fall off the drill press and get caught in here, and they're really hard to clean out. And having it here, they're always within view. I can see when there's one missing, and I don't get them full of chips. I bought this Fortuner bit set a while ago, and it came in a box and it mounted on this plate, but it keeps coming off, and they're really not that good. So I just recently bought a better set of Fortuner bits, and rather than having this thing get full of chips below the drill press, I want to mount this thing right about here. Whoops. These rivets always spin when you try to drill them, but if you go at them with an angle, that usually helps a little bit. So this thin plywood is going to be the backer, and I'm going to cut out a piece to fit around here. And then there's going to be this to hold it on the bottom. And to keep it from slipping out side to side, it's already got this tab, and I cut a tab into this piece of wood. And then I like the grain of this one here, so that's going to go on here something like this, just to get the slope off this piece of wood that I need to cut. I'm gonna let the glue dry on this for a few minutes just so it won't move around anymore for when I glue this part on. I'm putting in just a thin layer of glue. It doesn't need to be super strong, and this will cause it to dry up much quicker. I only gave that glue about 10 minutes, but I figure for this application it should be all right. Before I mount it on the wall, I'm just going to put a few coats of water-based varnish on there. This stuff dries really quick, so it's not going to take all day to do this. I still need to be able to get these drills out down here, so I can't go too low with this. But I think this height, yeah, that still works. So I can punch that in. I'll move it a bit further over this way. I'm just using some tiny little number four screws because I don't need a big hole in the wall. And it'll hold that well enough. And conveniently, the old screw holes are now covered up. Annoyingly, they all seem to lean to the left a little bit, so I guess this drill index wasn't really the highest quality there is. Making holders for all your tools is a great way to organize them and keep them within sight, but it's a lot of time commitment. It's very time consuming making holders for every single little tool that you've got. My favorite tool holders are those for the hand planes. No inclined plane, no magnets required, and they're secure. And of those ones, this is my favorite one. I carved this one out of a solid block of wood.